Good evening, my friends. Welcome to Evening Reflection, Day 6, Part 1.
Day 6, Thinking About My Purpose. Point to ponder: this world is not my home. Verse to remember: so we fix our eyes not on what is seen, but on what is unseen. For what is seen is temporary, but what is unseen is eternal. 2 Corinthians 4:18, NIV, question to consider: how should the fact that life on earth is just a temporary assignment change the way I am living right now? And the reason for everything comes from God alone, and everything is for His glory. Romans 11:36. The Lord has made everything for His own purposes. Proverbs 16:4, NLT, it's all for Him. The ultimate goal of the universe is to show the glory of God. It is the reason for everything that exists, including you. God made it all for His glory. Without God's glory, there would be nothing. What is the glory of God? It is who God is. It is the essence of His nature, the weight of His importance, the radiance of His splendor, the demonstration of His power, and the atmosphere of His presence. God's glory is the expression of His goodness and all His other intrinsic, eternal qualities. Where is the glory of God? Just look around. Everything created by God reflects His glory in some way. We see it everywhere, from the smallest microscopic form of life to the vast Milky Way. From sunsets and stars to storms and seasons. Living for God's glory is the greatest achievement we can accomplish with our lives. Creation reveals our Creator's glory. In nature we learn that God is powerful, that He enjoys variety, loves beauty, is organized, and is wise and creative. The Bible says, "The heavens declare the glory of God." Throughout history, God has revealed His glory to people in different settings. He revealed it first in the Garden of Eden, then to Moses, then in the tabernacle and the temple. The Bible says, "The city does not need the sun or the moon to shine on it, for the glory of God gives it light." God's glory is best seen in Jesus Christ. He, the light of the world, illuminates God's nature. Because of Jesus, we are no longer in the dark about what God is really like. The Bible says, "The sun is the radiance of God's glory." Jesus came to earth so we could fully understand God's glory. The Word became human and lived among us. We saw His glory, a glory full of grace and truth. God's inherent glory is what He possesses because He is God. It is His nature. We cannot add anything to this glory, just as it would be impossible for us to make the sun shine brighter. But we are commanded to recognize His glory, honor His glory, declare His glory, praise His glory, reflect His glory, and live for His glory. Why? Because God deserves it. We owe Him every honor we can possibly give. Since God made all things, He deserves all the glory. The Bible says, "You are worthy, Lord our God, to receive glory and honor and power. For You created everything." In the entire universe, only two of God's creations fail to bring glory to Him: fallen angels, demons, and us, people. All sin, at its root, is failing to give God glory. It is loving anything else more than God. Refusing to bring glory to God is prideful rebellion. And it is the sin that caused Satan's fall and ours, too. In different ways we have all lived for our own glory, not God's. The Bible says, "All have sinned and fall short of the glory of God." None of us have given God the full glory He deserves from our lives. This is the worst sin and the biggest mistake we can make. On the other hand, living for God's glory is the greatest achievement we can accomplish with our lives. God says, "They are My own people, and I created them to bring Me glory." So it ought to be the supreme goal of our lives.
Thank you for joining us for another evening reflection. We trust that the lessons being shared through Pastor Rick Warren's book, The Purpose with Life, will cause us to reflect on our own lives and to see whether or not we are in fact living a purpose-driven life. God bless you. Have a restful night. Bye-bye.